So this is to put in perspective the scale of the massacre that took place there. And it took place on November 1, 1984. It started sometime in the morning. It went on uninterrupted through the day, and the massacre continued on the second day, November 2nd. Now, we are talking about media cover-up. Now, this massacre took place in Delhi, as I said, not very far from the police headquarters, and not very far from even the media establishments on Bahadur Shah Zafar Marg and elsewhere. Of course, the TV channels were yet to come. The ones you see, again, not very far from Trilokpuri is the film city of Noida. Now, this place was not visited by any journalists on the 1st of November because nobody evidently knew about this massacre. The entire area was barricaded. All sorts of obstructions were put, big boulders, tires, and what have you. And so all the approach roads to Block 32 were blocked. And the massacre came to light the next morning only because of this fortuitous circumstance of one of the victims, one young man, managing to escape in the dead of night. And he, with great difficulty, reached police headquarters. And as was only to be expected, given the conduct of the police those days, he was shooed away from the headquarters when he went there to complain about the violence that was going on in his neighborhood. And then from there, he reached Bahadur Shah Zafar Marg newspaper offices. And finally, he approached a couple of reporters in Indian Express. Finally, I mean, that's where his lament, his complaint received a sympathetic hearing. It was from a journalist called Rahul Bedi and another a colleague of his called Joseph Malyakan. I don't know if these names mean anything to you. These two, along with a colleague from Jansatta, Alok Tomar, if I'm not mistaken, the three of them set out from there and reached the neighborhood of Block 32 Trilokpuri. They couldn't quite reach Block 32 itself because, as I said, there were all sorts of obstructions. And they could see the environment of fear and violence, and they could not make much progress. So they were, in fact, turned away by rioters. They were threatened, intimidated. So they went back. They approached some army truck they encountered on ITO bridge. They said, look, we don't have any orders yet. We ourselves are grouping around. We don't know where to go. So you have to approach the police headquarters. So that's how these people also went to the police headquarters. And they couldn't get them to take their information seriously. They said, no, it's all under control. There's no sign of, there are no reports of any violence. And at that point of time, even these journalists did not know, what was the nature of the violence that was going on, much less could they have imagined the scale of the violence. Because this is something that's unprecedented. And nobody would have imagined that something like this could have happened right in the capital of the country. But that's exactly what happened. And that's what they discovered when they went back a second time. In fact, it was the third time, because they had problems again and again in approaching. The third time they managed to enter the place, because their third visit coincided against all odds. I mean, you must give full credit to the spirit they showed. This was, I mean, I recall this in detail because it's one of those instances of journalism at its very best. They against all odds, went there a third time, and fortunately, it coincided with the visit of a senior police officer, Additional Commissioner of Police, Jatter. He was there because these people had already gone to the police headquarters and told senior police officers there about, you know, the magnitude of the problem in Trilokpuri. As a result of that, this man was forced to come finally. And then accompanying Jatter, they entered the place and saw for themselves the state of affairs in Trilokpuri. and how they had to, they described very vividly, very poignantly, how they had to pick their way through the lanes, those narrow lanes of Block 32, because, I mean, that lane was strewn with dead bodies and, you know, they were in different, I mean, there were all these mangled and maimed bodies and lots of people being burnt alive and so on. By then, in fact, the violence, the massacre had subsided. This was the evening of January 2nd. So you have to bear in mind, we are talking about, November 2nd. We have to bear in mind that this started on November 1st, the whole day, it went unchecked, the whole night of November 1st and 2nd, I mean, night intervening November 1st and 2nd, and it went on till the evening of November 2nd. This was how it was in 84 in Delhi. And now I want to cut to an incident that took place 3 days later at a place called Pahadganj on November 5. By then the violence had subsided. I mean the big killings, I mean by the official figures, as many as 2,733 people were killed in Delhi alone on the first 3 days of November 1984. And there were a few sporadic incidents after that. And on November 5 evening, there was one such incident at Pahadganj, not very far from Connaught Place.